Hello there. Welcome to the WCAG Documents project focused on web accessibility. My name is Shanice and I work as the delivery coach here at Acton Digital. And I will walk you through this part. In this video, I will talk about the WCAG criterion 1410 Reflow. And you can also read it online at accessibility.actomdigital.com, where you can find more information. So let's get into it. The intent of the success criterion is to ensure content adapts to a screen size without two-dimensional scrolling. Well, who benefits from it? All people with low vision can enlarge content and view it without the need of scrolling horizontally and reading long lines. Also, anyone, but especially users who struggle with reading, do not need to navigate in both directions to read the content. Reflow refers to ability of the web content to adjust and adapt to various screen sizes and zoom levels. It ensures that content can be presented in a single column or space that fits the viewport without the need of scrolling horizontally. This process involves dynamically rearranging, resizing, and repositioning the content to maintain readability and usability across different devices and conditions, such as when the text size is increased up to 400%. This is called responsive web design. All content and functionality must remain available in all screen sizes and zoom levels, either directly or revealed via accessible controls or accessible via direct links. Two-dimensional scrolling is acceptable for content that requires it for usage or meaning, such as maps, diagrams, videos, or games. To meet this success criterion, you can follow these steps. First, implement the responsive web design principles to ensure content reflows appropriately. Use the CSS media queries to adjust the content layout at a different zoom level or screen sizes. Avoid fixed-width containers that can prevent content from reflowing. Or test your website at various zoom levels, especially at 400%, to ensure that content reflows to a single column without horizontal scrolling. Let's take a look at some examples. The following example shows the correct usage or implementation of accessibility, so-called responsive website. This is an example of responsive website from decuniversity.com. It demonstrates how to make web content accessible and legible across various devices by using a viewport meta tag for scaling, setting the breakpoints for desktop, tablet, and phone views, adjusting the menu item visibility and layout, and ensuring images and content reflow properly to maintain the readability and usability at different screen sizes. The following example shows the incorrect usage or implementation of accessibility, so-called non-responsive website. This is an example of non-responsive website from decuniversity.com. This site illustrates the common pitfalls of non-responsive design, such as fixed-width layouts that don't adjust to different screen sizes, leading to poor user experience on the mobile devices and tablets. The content and images do not reflow or resize, demonstrating the importance of responsive design practices for accessibility and usability across various devices. And that was all for this video. Thank you for watching and see you in the next one. Have a nice day.